Let's examine how to calculate the relative strength index, or the RSI.
First, identify a previous time period to use. A time period is generally 14 days, but can be shorter or longer. Next, add up the average gains and divide by the average losses during your chosen time period. The calculation solution, or value, is referred to as relative strength. The relative strength value is then plotted on a graph between 0 and 100. Plotting a line helps investors measure momentum in relative terms, which means looking at the indicator's current value in relation to past values. This comparison may make it easier to identify when a stock might reverse its prevailing trend. To identify potential trend changes, there are two ranges of the indicator to keep in mind: overbought and oversold. Overbought refers to a stock that has increased rapidly in a short period of time and may reverse lower. Conversely, oversold refers to a stock that has decreased sharply in a short period of time and may reverse higher. Now that you know how to calculate RSI and how it measures momentum, let's look at how investors might use this indicator to identify potential trading signals. Some investors define oversold as an RSI value below 30. When RSI crosses back above 30, it generates a potential bullish entry signal. Exit signals work the same way, except investors use overbought values. An overbought value is an RSI value above 70. When RSI crosses back below 70, it generates a potential exit signal.